Welcome back, guys. As you can see, I restored my old save game. I went back to the start of the previous video. Unfortunately, as you can see in level 9, I've pretty much cleared out all the monsters that are around. There's a couple more, like these Deathstalkers over here, but they're kind of hard to get at, so I'm not going to waste a lot of time running after them. I think our best bet is to go out to level 10 and start killing some creatures up there. There's also this Yamrikya, or whatever it's called. The flying thing you saw just now, but unfortunately I cannot kill it with my magic attacks because it's immune to death magic. And death is the spell you want to upgrade, so there's no real point in attacking these guys. So yeah, I think our only choice is to go up to level 10. Now, the route to level 10 is all the way at the top, and you can see it just barely at the top of the screen if I jump here. Unfortunately, it needs a mantle to get to, so instead of doing that, I will use a black onyx instead. Just because it's more convenient and because I don't have any more mantles and I don't want to go all the way back to level 1 to pick one up. I think we've got plenty of black onyxes for the moment. Now, you have to be a little bit careful where you use this because you can easily get stuck in level 10 using an onyx, but I think this is a pretty safe place. Okay, now, if you remember from one of the earlier videos, these guys are extremely strong, so be very, very careful about attacking them with your melee attacks. These are actually immune to my death magic as well. Maybe that berserker. Maybe the copper dragons? Yeah, copper dragons will die. And they take a lot of hits. If you remember from the earlier videos I did, experience is actually built up on a per hit basis. So it doesn't matter how much damage you do or whatever, as long as you have a successful magic attack, it will increase your experience, regardless of whether it does 1 point of damage or 100 points of damage or 1000, it doesn't matter at all. It just counts the number of attacks you do. The same for leveling up your weapon or your armor. So the more hits you take with your armor, regardless of how strong they are, the more experience you'll get. So in that regard, these copper dragons are actually very good for us. Now, in addition to building up our spell experience, this will also increase our wizard experience, which is kind of lacking for the moment, so that's good. I'm considering, because a lot of these creatures drop pretty good items, I'm considering using a demon string just to yeah, I think actually I will. We still have plenty, so yeah. I think that's probably a good idea. Let me just check here real quick, see if these berserkers are worth it. Barely, but you know, whatever. So, we will use our magic to take out most of them. And then use our Demon's Ring to kill the last one with our melee attacks. Just so we get a lot of wizard experience, but we still get the nice item at the end. There we go. I hope this isn't too boring to watch. We've seen this a billion times before really by now, but since it's the final level, I just wanted to show you as much as possible, and doubly so because YouTube finally removed my time limit, so I can make longer videos now, which means we don't have to worry about our time limits anymore. In the meantime, let's have a quick look at our experience with our magic weapon. See, we went from, I think, 40-something to 72 already, so it's going pretty quickly. I think I need 100 or maybe 150 experience. So yeah, we'll definitely get there in this level. Sadly, these guys are immune, so we cannot attack them. Or we can attack them, but it's no use. Oh, these are immune too. Oh well. I guess we'll get some more experience with our weapon as well, that's not too bad. But you know what, I think we might want to leave these guys so we can get more experience with our final weapon. Because of course we are ultimately going after the Dragon Slayer, which is what the game is all about after all. Again, we can't hurt these guys with our magic, so we're going to leave them alone. I guess killing this final copper dragon will be okay. Let's quickly hope we'll find some more critters to kill before our demon's ring runs out. Here's one. Oops. Didn't mean to shoot that box, but whatever. At this point, gold is not going to be very important. We've got everything we need. I guess the only thing we might need more of is keys, but nah, we still have over 100, so we're not going to be buying anything anymore. Yeah, we have plenty of keys. Isis are immune again, so we're going to leave them alone. So many monsters immune to death spells, I think I might have made a little mistake in not leveling it up in the previous level. I think maybe level 9 would have been better to practice our death spell, instead of just getting... Yeah, see, these guys are immune too. What about you, Medusa? Thankfully, we can kill Medusas. Just check real quick if we're not losing anything important here. Okay. You die now. There we go. Anyone else? Isis, we don't need you. We do need you. Medusas apparently only drop red potions, so that's quite nice. No, yeah, there we go. Oops. Oh well, didn't mean to do that, we lost the red potion there, but not a big deal. Lost our demon's ring as well. Oops. Ow, ow, ow. Actually, I don't think that was that bad. And we can take a little damage from these guys, considering they give us red potions anyway. Not gonna risk another one. There we go, not too strong. So it looks like we're not getting out this way. There's another one more. Fortunately, it was just one of them, but oh well. I think there's one more spawn, right? Did we get three? Should be one more. Maybe not. As you can see, Isis also use death spells. Pretty impressive for a little monster. But easy to avoid if there's only one of them. Is there another way out of here? I don't think so. I think we might have just killed everything there is to kill in here. Because the other area, I think, is inaccessible. Except maybe if we use flying boots or something. But I'm not going to waste the flying boots on this guy, on these guys. Yeah, see, we just go all the way around. Yeah, I think we should have maybe gone to the other side. But you know what? I'm not too bothered about it. These sylphs, by the way, are karma creatures, so you have to be a little bit careful. As you can see, they don't really do anything, which is usually an indication that you shouldn't kill them. In this case, that's definitely true, because they give you a lot of karma, and in addition to giving you a lot of karma, they don't drop anything good, and they don't give you any experience, so yeah, not worth it, clearly. I think it's about time to go back to level 9, because I don't think we're going to be finding anything more of value here for the moment. Let me just check how much experience we built up in the meantime. 91, it's not ideal. I wanted to get up to 100. But there's a couple more monsters in the tower itself which we can kill, so hopefully those will get us over the over the limit. I guess we'll see. I'm not sure if this is the best place to use the fire crystal, but we'll see. We will go back to the previous level. Okay, that wasn't too bad. You know what, let's see if we can wizard up again. Not yet. So, I guess that's it. I guess we see now if we have done enough. Yep, this is the one we want. So let's head back to the tower, see if we can find some more monsters to kill, and get our death experience up high enough that we can finally attack the silver dragon with our magic attacks. I honestly don't know if we're gonna make it, but we will find out. First we'll light a lamp again. And you know what? Forget it. We are just going to try and kill them without using any special items, because we're strong enough now, I think. Yeah, these old jerks, they're still pretty deadly. But we can take them now. Oops. Oh. Killed another chest, what else is new? Some more free wizard experience, that's always good. Doesn't really matter, we'll go this way. These guys are a little bit hard to see because of the graphics glitching, but we'll have no trouble killing them. I think they throw all these guys at you because you might be a little bit low on keys at this point, and Decatons drop keys and pendants pretty much. I think it's just enough to get you through this tower or something like that. For us it's not too important because I've been stressing getting plenty of keys pretty much from the first level on. If you're playing through this game for the first time, that's going to be pretty tricky. There are a number of times where I've gotten stuck and had to completely restart the game just because I didn't have enough keys. It's pretty frustrating. So that door we passed earlier would actually, if we go through it, we'd end up in this room. It's another sort of teleport type thing again. So as we're walking back, I think it's the next room. Yeah, this is the one. So if we went through this door, we'd end up in the room with all the food, and we just have to walk back here. So I'm gonna skip that part. Check item experience real quick. Oh, we're over 100 already. That's good. We might actually get enough to kill him. Our mortal enemy. Oh yeah, these guys. I honestly don't know how much damage they do. I completely forgot, but I'm guessing if we're careful, we should be able to kill them. Yeah, not so bad. Not bad at all. I think it's just the vaults in this level that are insanely damaging. +5 large shield, unfortunately we had one already. It's smiling to us from the bottom of the screen. Oh well. Didn't intend to open that door yet, but we're gonna have to sooner or later. And we might have to reload again if this dragon kicks our ass. Oh, lost another red potion. Oh well. Not such a big deal. We'll pick up all the stuff on the way out. We don't really need it right now. Darkstalkers, those are a little bit different. I think those are pretty deadly, but we don't need their item. Jesus. As you can see, they are pretty deadly. You know what? I'm not going to reload. We have so many elixirs already, and we're not going to be using them at any other stage, so whatever. We have 5 more elixirs, so yeah. Considering you can't use elixirs for the boss fights anyway, pretty pointless. Let me check real quick now. Yeah, we could go ahead, but all that's there is a couple of keys, and I'm not looking for those right now. Oh, that's right, these guys. Oh, our magic is strong enough to kill them now. That's good. Let's just get rid of them. So the... yeah. Just get some more experience in here. Not sure, a pendant, okay. See again, they drop us plenty of keys to get through this tower at least. It's not going to be nearly enough to get through level 10, but yeah. That's only if you don't do it the tricky way, like I did just now with the Onyx and everything. Another door. Yeah, this also leads to a couple of boss fights, but we don't want to do that right now. Oops. God damn it, I'm not paying attention at all. You know what, again, I'm not going to bother. Whatever. Let's just get rid of him. I just want to see if we can kill the boss, because if we can't, we're going to reload anyway. Let's see what our death spell does to this guy. Yeah, we can easily zap this guy. Of course, we don't really need to, but whatever. Pick up all our 3 morning stars, which are completely useless to us now. These guys. And more keys. We don't really need them, but you can never have too many. Okay, so let's see if we can get our death spell up to an acceptable level for this fight. We are now one-shotting Otyuk, so that's a good sign. I think before it took two or three shots. Of course. Now these guys are kind of proving me wrong. But, you know, whatever. There we go. Okay, now let's get our health up to full. Actually, it doesn't really matter, does it? If we can't use our magic, we're screwed anyway. Anything else we need to equip? Yeah, let's get our... Of course, we'll double our int. That might help. Okay, the moment of truth. Wow, we can actually damage him. I just wonder if we're gonna be quick enough. Well, it looks like we might be, yeah. Only barely, but we did it. Okay, well that was a close call, but clearly worth it. We have now beaten the final boss before we can get on to the final tower in the game, where we will be chasing after the Dragon Slayer. Wow, I wasn't actually sure we were going to make this one. And it's official now, we are further ahead in this game than I've ever been before. That's pretty exciting. You know what, let's clear out the other bosses just so to show we can. I'm not going to let them hurt me anymore. Because I don't need any more lamps. And this will take us to the Kraken, I think? I think so. And I will also show you the place where... we can one-shot a Kraken now, so yeah, that's pretty nice. Yeah, I'll also show you the... the place we will definitely get our asses kicked. Let's see... Oh yeah, okay. These guys drop poison, so there's no need to be very careful about killing the last one. Now, if I'm not mistaken, there's a second boss here. Yep. Let's see if we can one-shot this guy. No, we can't. Which makes sense, because this is the level, what, 7 boss or something, and the Kraken was the level 1 boss, so yeah. Obviously there's going to be a big difference between these two. Let's be a little bit fancy and use a... no, not a balance. Pendant. Considering we haven't really used any of them so far. Not really necessary, but whatever. So yeah, this is the penultimate boss, the final guardian of the final room, which is another silver dragon. And we will hopefully be able to beat him with the same strategy we were using before. The reason I'm getting this close is probably obvious to most people by now. You shoot a lot faster if you are close to the enemy. If you stand at a distance, he might be able to get close to you before you kill him. As you can see, we were nearly at the back wall, so it was definitely necessary. You might think this is the Dragon Slayer after going through all this trouble, but it's not. The actual Dragon Slayer... Oops. See, I shouldn't talk and play at the same time. I didn't mean to pick up that poison, of course. So this is a luck blade. We've seen this one before. We actually already have something better, so we don't really need this. And this is the place I was talking about. So we've beaten the Silver Dragon, we've beaten the four-armed sword guy, we've beaten the Kraken, we've beaten the Grell, we've beaten even the mighty Silver Dragon. And all that has led up to this moment. I wasn't sure if I was going to show this in this video, but I figure, you know what, why not? We are not going to be able to beat him anyway. As you can see, our death spell barely dents him. We can sort of try and jump over him, which works. But as soon as he hits you from the front, you are dead. So yeah, you really kind of need the Dragon Slayer to kill this guy. Let's give it one more go. We'll use a red potion. As you can see, just like the previous one, he doesn't do as much damage from the top, so... Let's see what happens if we try that. Ooh, ah! I think items are actually disabled in this fight. I can't use the red potion. That's interesting. I didn't know that. Maybe I didn't do it right. Let's try one more time. Just once more. Okay, come on, guy. Nope, you really can't use items in here. That's interesting. Well, still insta-killed, so... And still barely damaging him, so clearly this is not the way to go. The red dragon is clearly out of our league for the moment, or the king dragon, I should say. So guys, that's pretty much it for level 9. As you can see, we've cleared out everything there is to clear out. We even killed the boss guy, the silver dragon, and the king dragon, of course, as you can tell, is not meant for us for the moment. I think this glove is actually meant to be taken with the dragon slayer instead. I think so. Oh well, anyway, thanks for watching guys, that concludes level 9, and I will meet you back when we get to level 10.